guys. Welcome to episode, I think it's 7 of my John Coltrane series. Appreciate you all checking in. Wes Unseld, another NBA great from the 70s. Great time in the NBA. People don't really remember it. Jazz and basketball do have some connections. We'll get into that at a different time. But we're talking now John Coltrane, 1965. And this was a very pivotal year for John. We've seen him go through his earlier sheets of sound, his innovations with Giant Steps. He's done My Favorite Things, had some pop commercial success. He's moved to Impulse, created what I thought was going to be this money-making, churning-out machine. Coltrane had his own ideas. Creed Taylor left the Verve, Bob Thiele takes over, and Bob Thiele gives Coltrane a license. Do what you want, John. Do whatever you want, John. And John is exploring the cosmos. He's digging out. He's going beyond even the numbers and the math of music. And he's just, I always say, he's interceding with us to the Creator. And it's not limited to that one belief system. It's a broader human experience. And this song we're listening to right now is Cool Said Mama. Recorded in 65, comes out after he dies. But to me, this is one of my favorite avant-garde Coltrane tracks. It really has a spiritual nature to it. It's beautiful. It has a lot of nice melody to it. But there's still a seeking quality to it. Coltrane, he's starting to lose the quartet at this point. Elvin, McCoy, Jimmy, at different times, they're all starting to wonder where John's going. You start to see other drummers like Rashid Ali show up. Farrell Saunders starts to play some with them. You start to see the quartet disintegrate. His wife Alice starts to play with him. I'm not the biggest fan of Alice Coltrane, but a lot of people love her. Another episode again on that, I guess, someday. But so let's dig right into what he does here in 65. The quartet plays Chim Chim Cheree. Nature Boy, of course, is one of the most beautiful melodies in human history. I love the version of that by Bobby Darin. Just fantastic. The quartet's still intact here. These four songs, Song of Praise, Brasilia, they're kind of one of the last real pure breaths of the classic quartet. A lot of these were reissued in the 90s. A lot of them are tougher to come by now. Old pressings of this stuff's pretty valuable. This was recorded in 65, comes out in 66. And now we see Farrell Saunders has joined the crew. Rashid Ali is playing the second drum. Album's still here. Even the titles, The Father, Son, the Holy Ghost, Compassion, Love, Consequences, Serenity. He's thinking about the afterlife. He's thinking about the purpose and the meaning. You gotta believe he's hoping that somehow he's making a difference. Few people in history of music have taken a more sincere approach to their art. The sincerity alone is enough to always kind of have me fasten my seatbelt. Even when the roller coaster is going to be a little bit more than I'm really wanting to go on, there's something about John and that sincerity that allows me to go there with him, that I won't do with Albert Isla, that I won't do with Archie Shepp. The love affair with Coltrane was strong with me. And these records I don't put on as much as I want to do. I've moved into an older man now than I once was, obviously. New thing at Newport. This is obviously Newport Jazz Fest in 65. And Newport probably wasn't ready for what Archie and John were doing at this point. I believe it's two separate sides for each player. But Impulse knew that they put Coltrane's name on it, and they would have some success. This is recorded in 65, comes out in 66. This, I Ascension record. It's one track, split on the two sides of a record. And I've often compared this record to an exorcism. The demons, they had to watch out because they were coming for them. Marion Brown's on this, Freddie Hubbard's on this, Alvin, Art Davis Garrison, Archie Shepp, Pharoah Saunders, John Chachai, Marion Brown, Dewey Johnson. It's just kind of a tour de force. Like what we're listening to, Ascension is not an easy listen. I find Ascension a tougher thing to sit through than what we're listening to now. I think as men, as we get older, we have to confront our fears. And I think Ascension in some way was Coltrane really staring into the pit and trying to find his way through. Here's Pula Fe Mama that we're listening to. Recorded in 65, comes out in 67. I found this, believe it or not, at a girl I was dating's grandmother's garage sale. So we're talking probably 1996. She's like, my grandma's having a garage sale. And I go over there. I found a few B.B. King records on ABC. I found this record. I found some great old Ray Charles stuff. So grandma must have been a pretty hip lady. I'm not guessing she put this on too often, but it's an important part of Coltrane's history. It comes out after he died, of course. Here's Ohm. Again, the personnel has expanded here. Joe Brazil on flute, Pharoah Saunders has joined them, Donald Garrett's on bass, along with Jimmy Garrison. I think it's one of those two bass records. Ohm, as you know, is the transcendental meditation. Ohm. And again, you can really feel the spirituality and the power of the searching that is John Coltrane in these later records. They're not going to be for everyone, you know. If you are into the softer side of music, these Coltrane records aren't going to be that accessible to most people. This is a transition, recorded in 65, comes out in 70. This is mostly classic quartet stuff, it looks like. Prayer and Affirmation, Prayer and Meditation, Transition, Dear Lord. So again, you can feel the spiritual nature of where John's going. On 65, we're still dealing with Live in Seattle. There's John. He's got Pharoah Saunders joining him on this. So again, this is going to be fairly out there stuff. It was war music, you know. This is Sunship, 65. It doesn't come out until 1971. And this is mostly classic quartet, it looks like, recorded in RCA Victor Studios in New York City, supervised by Bob Thiel. So this is first meditation for the quartet. This is recorded in 65, doesn't come out until 77. By that time, Impulse is no longer. And last, we have this Coltrane Live in Paris. This was recorded in July 27 and 28. It's got the classic quartet on it. There's some real beautiful moments on this. Coltrane plays some soprano sax on it. This didn't come out until 1995 or so. Beautiful stuff. Anyway, that wraps up 1965. It was a pretty important year for Coltrane. A real U-turn happens. He also starts having some health issues, sadly. And we'll document that in the next episode, the final episode. Thanks all for watching. You have a great day. Peace.